The ergothioneine is particularly fascinating because it's a longevity vitamin. And I think we're onto something with this idea of how much is in the food chain and how it's affecting us, especially a lot of evidence on neurological diseases, cognitive impairment, Parkinson's, and all these diseases where they show people that have cognitive impairment or Parkinson's compared to age-matched normal people, they have far less ergothioneine in their blood. And so is that cause of the problem or is that an effect from the problem? We don't know for sure, but it's worth evaluating for sure.